So I was born just in this apartment, and it was a workers' quarter. We were not too rich, we were not quite poor, but my father was a bank clerk, my mother was a dressmaker. It began with some very, not many important things, but it grew up. We were not allowed to go to park, to cinema, to theater, to play yard, to swimming pool, to wood. We were expelled. First of all, my father also was expelled from his job. Then Jewish children was expelled also from schools. Then we had to wear on the David Star. And so that last 2 years, and just then, in 1941, they began these deportations. And I was in one of the first family transport. It was in December 41. It was December 10th, and it was exactly 1 month after my 12th birthday. We recognized that it was different because just after coming there, men and women were separated. But several months we couldn't be in touch, and only we used to send some messages. And that it's very but important, these messages, because also this way also I started my drawings. It was in December. And I draw in Terezín my first drawing, and it is a normal childish drawings. There are two children, they built a snowman. And I smuggled this drawing to men's barracks to my father. And then my father answered me, "Draw what you see." So this drawing, I find this very important because it was my first drawing I created in Terezín, but in fact it is the very last one, really childish, because after this response from my father, I started to describe the everyday life in Terezín. And I was very diligent, perhaps, because I was a long time in Terezín, almost 3 years. And in these 3 years, I created more than 100 of these drawings. And today, these drawings are very important because it was forbidden to make pictures, to make photos, and it exists almost no picture materials from that time. And I also wrote a diary. So perhaps you can find the same things I describe in my diary. You will find perhaps an illustration to it. Many people write diaries because we need to express ourselves somehow. And many people, many children, but not only children, also the adults started to write diaries, started to write poetry also. People who never did it. Everybody needed to express something himself, to stay or to keep himself a human being. Because Terezín was a ghetto, it was a kind of concentration camp as well, but it was used for a propaganda. One of it was that they invited an international Red Cross Commission. And for this commission, for this event, part of Terezín was prepared like a stage. The old ones and the ill ones were sent away, and it was such an act of beautification. Everything was already so beautificated. They used this stage because it was such a stage. they used it for a film. And it is the only film which was created in Terezín, but it is a lie propaganda film created by German. Each drawing is very important, but some of them are more important. It is one of them. One day, a transport of children came to Terezín. These children looked terrible. We never before saw something like that, that they were dirty and ill and without shoes and in terrible conditions. And these children had to go under the, because they had lice also, and they had to go under the showers. And when they had to go under the shower, they started to cry and they wanted to escape. And they cried, gas, gas. And it was the first time we listened this word. We didn't know what it meant. We neither knew where from these children were. The first transport came to Terezín in November, but just in January 42, the transports went not only sent to Terezín, but also from Terezín away. Nobody knew where. It was called only East transport, transport to East. So we supposed to go. We were told that this new ghetto would be somewhere in Germany. We were carried in closed cattle carts, very pressed, 50 persons in one car, darkness and without air and light, about 48 hours on the road. And the train stopped, they opened the cars, and we were in hell. We were shocked, we didn't know where we were. We saw, they opened the cars. We saw a great area with many barracks, rounded with barbed wire, and behind there, there were some chimneys, smoking chimneys. We supposed that it was a factory or something like that. And from these 15,000 children, only 100 went through this selection. It was a miracle, it was a luck, it was my fate, it happened, it luck, that I was chosen to the right side. And that time it meant life, because they already, these prisoners who were helping there, they taught us there that is not a factory, it is a crematorium, and we took it with such a black humor. Tomorrow you will go through this chimney. So when we went to this washroom, and we were looking on the shower if either water or gas would come. So I was lucky enough that I survived the whole time with my mother together. And we returned together, but we never learned where my father died. Probably he was sent to gas chamber. At the end, we were chosen to a slave work and given in a transport, and we were sent to Germany in this open cattle carts. It was terrible because it was April, it was cold and raining, and we were almost without food. Really, one day we got one potato, the next day one spoon sugar, then nothing. Really, it was a terrible journey, and it lasted 16 days. And on May 5th, we were liberated from American army. So we stayed alive, but it was not such a luck as somebody perhaps expects, because we were too sick to enjoy it. And so we were looking where to sleep. There was no a place, we had nothing, and it was very difficult. There were some dormitories, they let you oversleep, but one night only. So we were staying on streets, and it was a very hard time. And then we were looking to get back our apartment. It is just this apartment in which I was born and I returned. But the memories were staying here, and it was very difficult to stay here. And I was with my mother only, and we couldn't stay alone. It was very difficult.